Hello everyone, and welcome to Keen Gamer's Weekly News Roundup. In a PlayStation blog post, the Demon's Souls remake showed off its character creator. The custom character mechanic was in the original game, but multiple new options have been added to further personalize your appearance. Scars, tattoos, and even teeth arrangement are all customizable, with a total combination of traits reaching over 16 million. The game's photo mode also gets a boost, with filter options and the ability to hide bulky weapons or armor pieces, and even manipulate the expression on your character's face. Demon's Souls comes out November 12th, along with the release of the PS5. The Medium was supposed to be a launch title for the Xbox Series X, but unfortunately has become yet another victim to the all-too-popular news of being continued. Bloober Team, the developers behind the psychological thriller horror game, cited COVID-related setbacks and the launch windows of other titles releasing around the same time as the reason for the delay until January of 2021. Regardless, the developers seem confident the delay will allow them to craft the game they wanted to make and promise to keep in touch with their fans. Speaking of delays, Control's next-gen version for the Series X and PS5 has been pushed to 2021. In a recent post by Remedy, they stated that they wanted the product to be awesome and needed additional time to work on it. Oddly enough, the Ultimate Edition is still on track to come out later this year, which happens to be the only way those who wish to play it on the new consoles will be able to play the new edition. This odd release order has earned some frustration from gamers who have seen other developers give away upgraded editions of their games for free. Call of Duty players will be relieved to know that their Warzone progress will carry over to Call of Duty Cold War. It looks as if both Call of Duty Modern Warfare and Call of Duty Cold War will have Warzone in common, as both stats and ranks will synchronize across the two. This is the first time in Call of Duty history that this has happened. Call of Duty has historically been a fragmented series, with different development teams taking turns making them so that one could be released every year. The fact that there is integration taking place on such a large scale between two different developers is impressive. Mass Effect Legendary Edition was announced by BioWare November 7th as a remastered trilogy of the original Mass Effect games. The Legendary Edition will include all the games, the DLC, weapons, and armor packs. The sci-fi series came out to critical acclaim, even if the ending of the third game fell short of some expectations. The remaster is set to release in spring of 2021. The announcement of the remaster wasn't the only news. We also got a hint that the next Mass Effect game is in the works and in early development. Marvel's Avengers did not quite release to the explosive success many of us were hoping for, and has cost Square Enix a pretty penny. Square Enix reported a loss of $48 million, as some rumored reports have come in that the game didn't sell nearly enough to cover costs. The general consensus of the superhero game was that it was good, not great, and apparently good was not enough to compensate the high dollar amount to make such a game. While Square Enix still did better as a whole this year versus last year due to the release of its other recent titles, time will tell if Marvel's Avengers will become profitable in the future. Thanks for watching this weekly roundup on Keen Gamer. Remember to like and subscribe for more gaming news every week.